and muscles.
Each part of our body is important. We do different things using different parts of our body. We use both our hands and legs to run, swim, climb a tree, skip a rope. Eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin are our sense organs. They help us to sense, that is, feel the world around us.
Kids, have you ever thought what these body parts are made of or how they are connected? Our body is made up of millions of tiny cells. Cells differ in size and shape. Now try and do this. Touch the front part of your leg below the knee and then touch the back of it. The front is hard, whereas the back of the leg is soft. Both the sides you touched would have made you feel that there are different things inside your body. The harder part at the front of your leg, which you felt, is the bone. And the softer part at the back is the muscle. Together, they make you perform most of the tasks you do in your daily lives. Movements like picking up a book, scribbling something in notebook, and moving knees towards chest are possible because of the bones in our body. Let us learn more about bones. Bones have a hard outer layer made of calcium. All the bones are connected with each other. These connections or meeting points are called joints. We can bend our body around the joints. We can feel the joints too. Do you know a baby has around 270 bones and an adult has 206? This is because some of our bones fuse as we grow up. The bone joining our hip and knee, the thigh bone, also called femur, is the largest bone in our body. All human beings have the same structure of bones. All the bones join together to form the skeleton. The skeleton is the framework which gives shape and support to our body. It helps us to move, gives muscles a place to attach themselves, and protects the soft organs inside our body from injury. Did you know that a bone doctor is called an orthopedist? Now, let us learn about the softer part of our body, that is, the muscles. Our bones cannot move on their own. They are covered with body tissues that expand and contract, thus causing movement. These body tissues are called muscles. Muscles make up nearly half the weight of our body. They provide the push and pull which the bones need to bring about the movement. there are more than 600 different muscles in our body. The only muscle exposed on the outside is our tongue. If we blink our eye, we move 200 muscles at one time. The smallest muscle is inside our ear. It is the muscles that help you to smile, frown, yawn, and kiss. There are more than 30 muscles in our face. The muscles in our body are covered by a layer of skin. There are some parts in our body which are neither hard nor soft. Touch your nose or the earlobe. These are neither bones nor muscles, but are called cartilages. These parts tend to be a little flexible. When we grow, it is actually our bones and muscles growing. We can make sure that our bones and muscles grow fast and remain in a very good condition by eating a healthy meal, exercising, and maintaining a correct posture. Now, let us understand the word posture. The way we sit, stand, or move is called posture. Good posture is very important. When we sit, we need to keep our back straight against the back of the chair and keep our feet flat on the ground. When we stand, we should keep our shoulders and back straight. When we walk, we should keep our body straight and swing our arms from the shoulders. Once we start sitting or standing in the wrong posture, our bones and muscles get used to that shape, and in the future, we will find it difficult to sit or stand straight. So, we should practice a good posture every day till it becomes a habit. So, always remember, healthy food, exercises, and proper posture are needed to keep us strong and fit.